Today, I am going to chat to some of the musicians in Daniel's company. They all belong to a flamenco guitar company and played on the 1st of February. Let's find out more about the origins of their company as well as how far they have come.
Welcome to Latest TV. Can you tell me a little bit about your company and how this all started, as well as what's going on tonight?
Sure. Well, we've been friends for many years and been working together for many years. But Danny moved to Edinburgh in 2015. And from there, I mean, he'd been composing for many years with lots of ideas and lots of projects in his mind. So in 2017, he got us all together and he said, "Look guys, I want to create a show. I've got this project in my mind. I want to create this show with all of you involved, and I want to present it in Edinburgh, on a big stage, in a big theatre." So he decided to present the show in the Royal Lyceum Theatre in Edinburgh, and we were all like, "Oh my God, really? Wow, that's huge. Are you sure?" And he said to us, "Yep, you know, if we're going to start this, we're going to start big." So we named it, Art of Believing, and we presented it there at the Lyceum. It was sellout, absolutely fantastic evening. And from there, it all began, really.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you excited to be playing in Brighton, or any nervous attitude towards it?
Yeah, very excited, I think all of us, because it's a big responsibility, but very beautiful, and it's all out again, Art of Believing, and 2 weeks before the show. So yeah, very big responsibility, but yeah, looking forward for that.
So the music relates to traditional Spanish guitar. Have there been any modern improvements to this?
Well, this is, as you said, is a Spanish guitar, but we have added like a violin, which is something like give us all the power and the different style that we want to, and we have added a bass too. So it's weird because we need to think that this is a guitar show, so everything that we do, choreography, violin, bass, everything is focused on the Spanish guitar. So we don't want to leave the traditional things, but why not? We are trying to bring another air, and so there are many things really, really special.
Yeah, so basically Art of Living is a representation of my life, and I started playing with 7 years old in the conservatoire, and yeah, in the conservatoire played flamenco guitar soloist. However, of course, it's flamenco. Flamenco, you have to learn with the accompany singing, accompany dancing at the same time, you know, you play solo. So I'm trying to represent this, the thing that I studied in all my career in the conservatoire. And yeah, at the same time I was composing, for example, in my show, there is it's not a tribute, it's like, it's special for me because, for example, accompany singing solea is very important, no? The cante singing in flamenco is very important. We call like the modern flamenco, and solea also, this style in flamenco is very important. So basically, yeah, this like this. After that, for example, during the show, there is like, how you can call like at the end of the Rumbeña tango, it's like...
Well, as we live in Scotland, that's a surprise, so I don't want to train it. But there is some like folk music, like folk from Scotland. Yeah, yes, so it's a bit of fusion. Yeah, you will see.
Flamenco class, flamenco guitar. At the same time, he's playing the violinist. He's coming from Canarias also, and yeah. So it's like with him, it's very easy to improvise with another fusion, like another style of music. And so yeah, it's like everything, and very traditional music, flamenco, and then like a little bit more improvisation.
Yeah.
How has the tour been going so far?
Fantastic. Well, from 2017, We have visited Birmingham a couple of times. We've been to the Cardiff Guitar Festival. Tomorrow, for example, after doing the show here in Brighton, we're going to Birmingham's Royal Conservatoire's Guitar Festival. They've invited us to play there.
Yeah.
So we're really excited
about
that.
Very big responsibility again, because it's sold out a week before the show also, and it's a guitar festival. So it's like, I don't know, it's special, no? Because there's a lot of classical musician there, so with the guitar, and yeah, so for me as guitarist, I don't know, it's like a challenge, no? To play there with David Russell, for example, no? So like,
flamenco is having a space,
UK,
no?
Yeah, exactly. That's really good. Very happy with that, yeah, and also sold out. Very good answer from the audience. So,
yeah, and last night we were in Surrey, and also last year we did the Edinburgh Festival Fringe, which we're doing so this year as well. So really excited, you know, lots of projects ahead.
Yeah.
Lastly, are there any future plans for the rest of 2019 and beyond?
Yes, well, we've got another few productions coming out throughout the year, so we'll publicise them on our website and our social media. But we're extremely excited about the Edinburgh Festival Fringe 2019. You know, we're going to be playing for 24 nights in a fantastic venue, the Space UK. So a really big venue, number 38, and there's 130 audience capacity, so we're really, really excited about that. So that's gonna be fantastic. So we hope that from all the cities we've visited so far, that you know people travel up to Edinburgh because it's a fantastic festival. So we're really excited, really excited about that.
Okay, thank you for coming in today, and good luck on your show tonight.
Thank you.
Composer and flamenco guitar soloist Daniel Martinez presented his unique musical production, and it was truly awe-inspiring. I enjoyed a rich variety of flamenco styles, and it was a fiery performance. Now it's time to chat to some of the musicians after the performance to find out what they thought of performing in Brighton.
I think it was a great show tonight. We had one last night, and we really suffered. I just felt that tonight it was magic, because we needed it, because yesterday was a mess, but we really needed it, and Brighton is gifted. Mm-hmm. The people is gifted. I've been here a couple of times, and I always felt like a home. Even when I haven't lived in here, I would love to, but anyway,
fantastic. There was such a warmth from the crowd. I mean, you mentioned the people here at the venue at Old Market. They've been absolutely fantastic all day. They've really made us feel welcome, settled us in, sorted us out so that we could concentrate on what we were doing on the stage. And it really, you know, paid off. You know, the warmth from the crowd. We reacted, and it just seemed to bring the whole thing up. It was a special experience.
Anyways, guys, it was a truly fiery performance, and I would welcome you back in Brighton anytime.
Ole, thank you.
Thank you for coming in the latest TV.